Ireland has reached a deal to give back to Nigeria 5.5 million euros, which is about $6.5 million looted by former military dictator Sani Abacha. Helen McEntee, Ireland Minister of Justice and Equality, said the memorandum of understanding followed an order recently issued by a court in a European country regarding the funds. The Ireland Criminal Assets Bureau froze the loot in 2014 on the request from the administration of then-President Goodluck Jonathan. The money is the latest Abacha-linked cash reclaimed by Nigeria. Corruption watchdog Transparency International estimates that Abacha, who ruled from 1993 until his death in 1998, stole as much as $5 billion of public money during that time. And joining us live is Suleiman Arubagu, Executive Secretary of HEDA Resource Center. Thank you so much for joining us.
Yes, thank you. Good morning. Thank you for having me.
You're welcome. Are you excited, like some Nigerians, with this news? And of course, the reason a lot of people are happy is that recent history suggests that these funds are plugged into developing infrastructure.
Well, there really isn't anything to be excited about. What's important is that we keep our feet firmly on the ground and see how the government plans to. I mean, I'm sure the government is going to inform us how they intend to utilize this new repatriated fund, as they have informed about others. I want to see how judicious this will be used. Previously, they have invested some in social investments. There are some that have gone into infrastructure. And now this one, we don't know where it is going to go to, but we are waiting to hear from government. What's important is to see how judiciously they can use. So this is a shame, really. It's a shame on Nigeria. It's a shame on the international community that is repatriating Abacha loot over 20 years since the death of the late dictator. This particular 5.5 million euro, Ireland is telling us that the money has been frozen since 2014. Was it stolen in 2014? Okay, prior to freezing it in 2014, how active has that money been in the economy? You see, it is instructive that after closing each of these deals, Nigeria needs to do a public report of the processes involved, of the cost of repatriation, of what concessions we have to make. Because the citizens of many of these countries where stolen funds are kept need to know how their government and their economic system, their banking system, is aiding to progress countries like Nigeria.
Hold on, Suleiman. I was just about to get to that point. How do you feel that we can be more comfortable with the process of accountability and transparency of these repatriated funds?
Sincerely, it is a mixed feeling. This present government, and I'll tell you, my organization, HEDA Resource Center, and some partners in CISNAC, that Civil Society Network Against Corruption, we audited the first Abacha return, which was supposedly monitored by World Bank and meant to do projects across the country. And I can tell you for free that that money was relooted. Some of the projects are being implemented in local government that do not even exist in the Nigerian constitution. Just to say that many of it existed in there. But when this government came, the first Abacha return that it got was rightly pushed back to the people. We know of the social investment program formerly headed by Mariam Uwe. And they made some good progress in ensuring that the money actually got into the hands of people. The politicians were not satisfied because it was not channeled through them. They were not satisfied because they felt it reduced their power in the areas of influence. And they fought, since the 8th Assembly, they fought the lady, fought our process, fought our agency, till they were able to hijack it. And unfortunately, as the President Muhammad Bin Buhari has said, he set up another ministry, which was totally unnecessary. Put a politician there, and everything that we are afraid of will happen is already happening.
So what would you rather suggest in the management of these funds and, of course, other repatriated funds, if we keep getting them, how would you prefer that the Nigerian government handles these funds?
You see, already the first thing that the government does, which is good, is to say, this money that is coming, this is where we are going to push. So the Nigerian challenge is not lack of ideas on how to do things. It is the fact that those who will eventually implement do not give accounts, and they are not held accountable by the system. So if Nigerian government says we are spending this on infrastructure, we need to be able to follow the money to see that, okay, what they want to spend on it is judicially allocated, the procurement process is proper, the project is relevant, and it's delivered. Nigeria already has a lot of gaping holes that needs to be filled. So each of these money that comes is an opportunity to fill some of those gaping holes that our budget is unable to take care of immediately. But unfortunately, if the process is such that a minister or a director of an agency will utilize the public fund and there's no process of accountability, there's nothing to be excited about.
All right, we'll keep watching and see how things eventually turn out with this one. Thank you so much for sharing with us this morning, Suleiman.
You're welcome. Thank you very much.